Hello, Star Wars Rebels fans. My name's Joel Robinson, and this is Star Wars Rebels Theory Crafting. So, in the last two episodes of Star Wars Rebels, you may have noticed a lot of talk about Ezra Bridger's parents. Ezra describes his parents as fighting against the Empire through broadcasting anti-imperial messages. Sipo gives us greater information. They were taken away by the Empire, most likely because of their anti-imperial propaganda. So what happened to Ezra's parents? Well, Ezra thinks they're dead, but isn't quite sure. Sipo knows something greater about what happened to them, to which he reveals to Hera, but not to us, the audience. So this is where we get into some heavy theory crafting, so bear with me here. We know that if the Empire was going to kill Mira and Ephraim, there's a large chance they would have done so in the Bridger's home, like they did to Luke's family in A New Hope. It is therefore apparent that the Empire took them away to be questioned. We know from A New Hope that such interrogations are common, like when Leia was questioned with the use of an ITO interrogator droid. It is my belief that the Bridgers were able to resist the torture given to them by the mind probe. Why? Because I also believe that the Bridgers are Force-sensitive beings. The reason is, Ezra is strong in the Force, and we know that the most common way for a child to be sensitive with the Force is for it to be inherited from a family member. So if Ezra's parents are strong with the Force, they would have an easier ability to resist torture or interrogation. I do not, however, believe that Ezra's parents are Jedi, for if they were Jedi, then Ezra would already know about the Force. Also, if they were Jedi, they would have an opportunity to turn to the dark side. Now, if they did not turn to the dark side, the Inquisitor would kill them. So where are Ezra's parents? Well, there's a large chance that they're dead, which is a real bummer. I know. But I really doubt that the Empire would keep a prisoner for 8 years. Another theory is that they could be frozen in carbonite. We know that from the Clone Wars series that Darth Vader had used the carbonite technique to store a body before using it on Han Solo in the Cloud City. The Empire could be storing their bodies for later use, kinda like they did with Master Luminara's body in Rise of the Old Masters. Of course, you know, they would be alive and not actually dead. Now, if they made themselves useful to the Empire, they could still be alive as prisoners. But the greatest possibility still is that they're dead. Yet, in the Star Wars universe, no one ever really dies. They simply become a part of the cosmic force. Who knows? Maybe they'll show up as a blue ghost. Whatever the outcome is, I'm sure we'll find out soon when Star Wars Rebels premieres again in January. Thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure to comment and subscribe. And may the Force be with you, always.